Hello everyone. Welcome to the webinar, Building Safe, High-Performing Systems Just Got Easier. How QNX and NXP i.MX application processors streamlines the development of real-time safety-critical applications. This webinar is presented by Toradex, BlackBerry QNX and NXP. My name is Leonardo Veiga. I am the technical marketing team lead at Toradex. Before we begin, I would like to give you a few tips so you can take the best out of this presentation. The first of them is that this webinar is being recorded and will be available a few days after, so you can watch it on demand. Throughout the presentation, we will run a few polls so you can interactively answer multiple choice questions and we can learn more about you. Also, at the end, we will host a live Q&A section. And therefore, throughout the webinar, you can submit questions and we will read them and answer them at the end live. I'm pleased to have with me today Robert Thompson, Director of the Global MPU Ecosystem at NXP, Thomas Dalelis, Field Application Engineer at BlackBerry QNX, and also his colleague, Malte Munst, who will participate of the Q&A section, and Andrea Jutta-Bilter, Regional Sales Manager at BlackBerry QNX. Before we begin, I'll quickly cover the agenda so that you have a better overview of the webinar flow. In the beginning, I'll talk briefly about Toradex, and then we will learn about QNX and the first steps. Then we will have an overview about safety and security on i.MX 8 and i.MX 8X from Robert. And after we see all this theoretical information, we'll have a demonstration about how to get started with QNX on Apalis i.MX 8. It will be a hands-on demonstration. And to wrap up, you will learn how to engage with QNX and Toradex. And then we will proceed to the live Q&A. Toradex is an ARM system on modules manufacturer. We focus on reliable and long-term available computer on modules. They are also meant to be scalable and available from stock. While different operating systems can run on our hardware, today's focus is on BlackBerry QNX. Toradex strives to provide easy of use to our customers, a premium support, and a vast ecosystem in order for you to bring your products to the market faster. Toradex has a global presence with offices across the globe. The top markets our customers are inserted in are industrial automation and healthcare, and also transportation, test and measurement, and smart cities. And the annual volumes ranges from a few hundreds to a few thousand computer modules. Toradex product portfolio is divided into three families of computer modules: the Apalis, Colibri, and the Verdin family. Within a family, all computer modules are pin compatible, and that means you can begin your evaluation or proof of concept on a powerful hardware, and as you optimize your software, you can easily migrate to a more cost-effective hardware. On the other hand, if you need new features in the future, you can easily switch to a more powerful hardware as well. Those families are equipped with NXP processors from the i.MX lines, from i.MX 6 to i.MX 7, i.MX 6 ULL, and on our new family, the Verdin, we have computer modules with i.MX 8 mini and soon the plus. And here I also highlight Apalis i.MX 8, which has NXP i.MX8 Quad Max and Quad Plus, and also Calibri i.MX8X. And those are highlighted because they are very good fit for running QNX on Toradex hardware, and you will learn more about that later on the presentation. Those also already have QNX BSP ports already available so that you can get started very quickly. Before I transition the presentation to QNX, I would like to run our first poll and understand how familiar are you with QNX. I'll keep it open for a few seconds so everybody has a chance to vote, and then we can see the results. Just a few more seconds as I can see the votes are coming in. Good. We can see that 1/3 of the audience is not familiar with QNX, and the other 2/3 have some knowledge to some degree. Now, I would like to invite Thomas to take over the presentation and present QNX to us.
Okay, so it looks like there's quite a good mix of people that have various levels of knowledge. So what I'll be doing is presenting a very brief introduction to QNX and our Neutrino RTOS. QNX was founded in 1980, just over 40 years ago. And I guess newer guys like me here tend to pronounce it as QNX, but you hear some of the old timers here sometimes pronounce it both as QNX, like Unix, as well as QNX. So we're headquartered in Ottawa, Canada, and have a global presence with engineering and sales teams across North America, Europe, and Asia. We're active in most embedded vertical markets with strong foundational products like our QNX Neutrino RTOS and our Mendix tool suite. We can provide you with a solid base for your development so you can truly focus on developing your intellectual property. So what I'd like to do next is give you the briefest of introductions to the core of the QNX RTOS and some of its associated technology. So to set the stage, let's consider at the highest level QNX and maybe an OS that you might have had some experience with to compare and contrast, like Linux. If you have developers that have developed applications for Linux, from this perspective, you're going to find that you'll be able to get up to speed developing applications based on the QNX Neutrino RTOS quite easily. This is because QNX is built from the ground up to be fully POSIX compliant. And this means if you've been orienting on POSIX APIs when developing your applications, or have code you've prototyped under Linux, you're going to find that it'll be relatively easy to port to QNX. But unlike Linux, QNX Neutrino was designed to be a real-time, fully deterministic operating system. As we'll see coming up, the underlying architecture of QNX is fundamentally different from Linux. QNX is architected to allow you to master complex embedded design without having to modify the kernel itself to do this. So I mentioned QNX is fundamentally different from Linux. What does the QNX architecture look like? QNX Neutrino is a microkernel. On the left side, we represent QNX, and on the right side, Linux, which is a monolithic kernel. But really, it could represent any OS or RTOS with a monolithic kernel. In a monolithic kernel, everything from the basic OS services to device drivers to protocol stacks and so on is contained in the kernel and all running in one big kernel address space at a privileged CPU level. So consider the implication of that in a monolithic kernel. You might have a driver or a stack, and that may have a bug, and that bug may have the ability to take down that entire system, you know, given the privileged CPU level it's running at. So what about QNX? Everything runs in its own address space, and only the microkernel itself is running in privileged mode. With QNX, the microkernel is designed to contain only the fewest possible components with unrestricted CPU privileges. And this boils down to just CPU scheduling, inter-process communication, interrupt redirection, and timers, and that's it. Everything else is implemented outside the kernel space, each as a process in its own protected address space. So, you know, drivers, stacks, your application, everything. A fault is contained so that it can only affect the faulty component. It doesn't have the level of privilege necessary to affect any other component. And this is an inherently safer and arguably more secure design than any monolithic kernel can offer. Failed components can even be dynamically recovered while the system continues to operate. So if a driver or application goes down, you have the ability to detect and recover this without needing to restart the system. QNX's microkernel architecture affords strict isolation between components, but we also provide an additional level of isolation for components that need to exchange information with each other. The kernel provides message passing mechanisms as a means of communication for processes. It's a synchronous method of inter-process communication mediated by the kernel. It's a proven and safe mechanism for well-controlled component interaction. The kernel additionally provides security mechanisms so that only the components you want talking to each other are allowed to talk to each other. Basically, message passing provides another way of isolation. It ensures a clean architectural decoupling in addition to the underlying microkernel. And this ability to partition or to isolate becomes an important concept when we talk about safety in a bit. And when we talk about isolation, spatial separation is arguably the most important. As we learned, the code you will develop will end up as processes, protected from others, and others are protected from it. From your application's perspective, memory assigned by the MMU to your process will look like contiguous memory for you. Also very important is temporal separation. This is important when we talk about QNX being real-time and deterministic. So time-critical, safety-critical aspects of all components behave deterministically in your system. Threads you define as more critical will not be slowed down by threads you define as less critical, all based on the priority you give them. And being POSIX compliant, you'll discover it'll be relatively easy to take in some of that great existing functionality out there from the open source world if you need to. And as we learned, separation mechanisms provide a way to ensure that the code you've brought into your device can't accidentally take down other processes. And while open source is usually unsupported, you know, if it really comes down to it, you can get any level of support required through our professional services team for bug fixes or porting. It doesn't matter if it's our component or yours or open source or hasn't been developed yet. We'll work together with you to ensure that that you're successful. Well, that was a really condensed introduction to the architecture of the RTOS. But basically, when you think about QNX, remember the microkernel and the inherent safety this affords compared to any monolithic kernel. Now, let's have an even quicker glimpse at the QNX development environment. The QNX Momentix IDE is based on the industry standard Eclipse platform. And given Eclipse is quite widely used in the industry, we often talk to teams that have encountered or used Eclipse at some point in their engineering careers. And given its Eclipse, all the third-party tools available from the Eclipse open source ecosystem are available to you as well. We also supply a tool called the QNX Software Center, and that's used to manage the QNX installation. So everything delivered by this tool is delivered in a secure manner to you. It's used to get the installation components, patches, and updates to you. And everything in the QNX build process that can be driven by the Momentix IDE or managed by the QNX Software Center tool can also be driven via command line. So the QNX development and build processes can be easily integrated into your automated build and continuous integration environments. On top of typical build and debug functionality, we've integrated innovative profiling and analysis tools into Momentix for maximum insight into system behavior. For example, you know, system and memory analysis tools, CPU profiling tools, and kind of the others you see here. But also little things that simplify your day-to-day development activities, like being able to drag and drop files from your host into the target. Well, that picture is kind of worth a thousand words, and we have a lot of pretty colors going on here. But beyond the underlying Eclipse IDE, for example, We see here what threads are running on what cores, CPU activity. We've got memory analysis going on over here, CPU partitioning budgets, and so on. And when you take part in the tools training we offer, you'll learn a lot about how to use our tools to analyze and debug typical scenarios. For a glimpse of the IDE in action, you know, check out some of our videos. By the way, we'll see additional slides like this with other relevant links. I won't dwell on these, but they are present for you to refer back to if you grab a copy of this webinar. So, as the power of compute platforms increases in the embedded domain, designers have the luxury to add more functions on each SoC. These functions can be driven and combine safety critical and non-safety critical processes. The challenge is to isolate these functional domains such that they do not impact each other negatively. But also sometimes there is a need to port legacy software on newer hardware without changing the underlying OS. And for this, we have a powerful yet flexible hypervisor. The QNX hypervisor provides you the flexibility to configure what natively runs in the QNX host OS mixed with what you have running in your virtual machine. So we scale on the right from a thin, small and efficient hypervisor that supports multiple isolated guests, and actively a little more than a type 1 hypervisor, all the way to a thicker type 2 operating system environment here on the left, where you might be using, you know, VirtIO based device virtualization, you know, while having other critical functionality implemented directly in the QNX host OS. So briefly, the QVM provides virtual CPUs and the ability to use either virtual devices or pass through to access your hardware directly. Each VM has networking support as well as its own security policy. We can support unmodified Android, Linux, and QNX guests, and others down to things like simple code running on bare metal. If there's some other guest OS you require, you know, let's talk and see what we can do for you. For complex applications like multiple guest OSs sharing a GPU, audio, or other devices, we have an advanced virtualization framework we can optionally offer if you need to share access to such resources between guests. As the hypervisor host is essentially a QNX microkernel with extensions for virtualization, you also have a complete POSIX environment in the hypervisor. There's also a server monitor for timeout detection and recovery. And to reiterate, it's your choice per your design whether you want to use it as a type 1 or type 2 hypervisor. And in the, at the top here, you are your guest domains that we saw on the previous slide. And we were able to certify the hypervisor, I believe the first vendor in the industry to do so, to the highest SIL levels. That's 61508 SIL 3 and ISO 26262 ASIL D. So with an RTOS that provides temporal and spatial separation and a hypervisor providing strict isolation between guest OSs, we've kind of set the stage for what I'll wrap up with. That's functional safety. And one definition is it's the absence of unreasonable risk due to hazards caused by malfunctioning behavior. So in today's world, there's an ever-growing need for detection of potentially dangerous conditions. This results in the need to take protective or corrective action, for example, to prevent a hazardous event arising or providing some mitigation to reduce the consequences of a hazardous event. We talked earlier about time and space partitioning, you know, inter-process communication mechanisms, as well as virtualization. But let me introduce the concept of bus master caging. For devices with SMMUs, that's system memory management units, QNX can use the SMMU, for example, to prevent DMA devices from accessing memory outside your defined boundaries. For example, protecting against a DMA-based I/O device from writing to memory outside its defined scope. And not only is this functionality necessary for safety, but I hope you begin to see that this also leads to being able to develop systems with QNX that can be secure. So everything we've been talking about up to now sort of leads to the concept called freedom from interference. You hear about freedom from interference talked about in the automotive space, but it's really applicable to any safety critical system. That's where a fault in a less safety critical software component will not lead to a fault in a more safety critical component. And this becomes very important when we talk about mixed criticality systems. For example, you know, how could a safety critical and non-safety critical or functionality coexist on the same platform and be certified? With the QNX Core OS, we've seen it can provide freedom from interference using time, space, and resource access separation. Further isolation can be provided using a hypervisor, as we discussed. With this, we can allow heterogeneous systems, you know, for example, mixing combinations of Linux, Android, and QNX to be developed. But most importantly, you can use both our Core OS as well as the hypervisor, if necessary, to create systems of mixed criticality, where one component may be safety critical, residing alongside some less or non-safety critical component. And this gives you the ability to consolidate what was in the past multiple systems into a single platform. And the ability to separate critical and non-critical components can reduce your certification effort. In typical examples, we encounter customers wanting to run guests with Linux or Android for their user interfaces, while their critical components are running either in QNX natively in the host OS or as another QNX guest. QNX also provides a comprehensive approach to security that builds on OS features. This incorporates industry standards such as a chain of trust, integrity management, mandatory access control, and so on. And where it makes sense, the security configuration is described in a central policy repository. This allows system architects and integrators to specify, implement, and review security policies for devices. Security is achieved using different optional security mechanisms. Each feature adds a different layer of security and serves a different purpose, and our solution provides the ability to audit and attest to the integrity of the system. And so with this, I'd like to pause it here, and Robert at NXP will continue the discussion about safety and security in the i.MX8 architecture.
Thanks, Tom. For those of you who are not familiar with NXP, a quick overview. NXP is one of the leading semiconductor companies in the world, covering markets as diverse as automotive, mobile, smart home and city, and industrial, the market we will focus on today. We have a long history and a worldwide presence that enables industry-leading customer support across all of our products. Out of all NXP products, today, we will be focusing on the i.MX portfolio of application processors. So what are the i.MX key values? The i.MX portfolio is based on trust, scalability, and industry-leading enablement. Trust has been earned through shipping over 400 million processors, many to industrial customers that value long life cycles, of 10 to 15 years, baseline to advanced security features, and qualifications for all usage models, but specifically the industrial that is tested to 10 years always on, to minus 40 to 105 Celsius junction temperatures. All i.MX processors are part of a portfolio that enables scalability across many usage models and use the same board support packages to enable software reuse. To enable wide availability of all key design materials are posted to nxp.com. Support is available via communities, and parts are available through all major distributors. However, we realize we cannot meet all customers' needs alone, so work very closely with key partners such as Toradex and QNX. So let's look at how all of these key values are represented in the latest i.MX portfolio, the i.MX. Building upon the success of the industry-leading scalability with the i.MX 6 series, the i.MX 8 series is a highly scalable product family that provides full ARM V8A 64-bit support while maintaining seamlessly backwards compatibility with 32-bit ARM V7A software. Today, we are going to focus on the i.MX 8 and 8X families. The i.MX 8 family is focused on advanced graphics and CPU performance, as well as vision processing for industrial and automotive customers. It has up to two ARM A72 cores, up to four A53s, two M4 cores, and an integrated DSP. The i.MX 8X family is focused on safety certification and efficient performance for the industrial markets. It has up to four A35 cores, an M4 core, and an optional integrated DSP. These two families are shown on this slide, have approximately 70% subsystem reuse, so enabling a high level of software and hardware reuse across the full range of product capabilities. The subsystem reuse also extends into future versions of the 8 family, so ensuring that developers have a scalable platform where software and security features developed can be reused, creating not only a scalable, but a secure and safe platform. So let's look at the safety features offered in the i.MX 8, 8X families. The safety features included in the 8X are power clock and temperature monitoring, CPU register protection, display domain partitioning for failover safety, and EEC memory, error correction code memory. This last feature enabling SIL3 certification. EEC on the 8X DDR3L memory interface means that any industrial customer can achieve industrial SIL3 certification by using the 8X in combination with a safety certified RTOS on the A cores, for example, the QNX Neutrino. This architecture also addresses the needs of customers that request lockstep cores. We have been working around this requirement with our digital networking products for telecom applications and avionics customers for a number of years. So we have talked about the i.MX 8 scalability and safety. Now let's look at the security features we offer customers. As you can see on this slide, the i.MX offers a full suite of security features. To hit the highlights, in terms of baseline security, executing trusted and authentic code on an application processor starts with securely booting the device. The 8X family provides this capability with the advanced high assurance boot component on the on-chip ROM and the security controller firmware. The advanced high assurance boot in ROM is responsible for authenticating the security controlled firmware, which is signed by NXP, which will supply the services for authenticating the image signed by the user to the system controlled ROM. The secure boot architecture, along with secure storage and secure debug via the authenticated debug module, creates a best-in-class baseline security for any industrial device. This baseline security is then built on with physical tamper detection, covering voltage and temperature monitoring, manufacturing protection with two roots of trust in the chip. One is NXP public and the other is for the OEM. For those customers looking for advanced security features, we also offer key protection and revocation. For key protection, we support boot time acceleration of the hashing function, crypto key protection, and HDCP authentication. Strong partitioning is supported through virtualization. Both the 8 and 8X families offer full chip hardware virtualization with resource domain protection. Each IP block has hardware-based resource protection stitched around, enabling the creation of distinct platforms with CPU-GPU architecture and specific peripherals assigned. Any communication between domains are forced to use messaging protocols through messaging units. If a domain peripherals tries to access other domains illegally, a bus error will occur. One of the benefits of this is to provide security on a finished product by protecting system-critical peripherals from less trusted applications and intentional security breaches. So this was a brief overview of NXP, the i.MX 8, and how its safety and security features can be the basis of building a safe, high-performance system. Now I'm going to hand you back to Leah, who will show us a hands-on demo using the components discussed so far. Leah.
Thanks, Robert. And now I'm going to show a hands-on demo that I have pre-recorded due to the limitations we have with time here on the webinar. And I've speed up a bit the video. Usually it will take around half an hour to a few hours to go through all the steps. I will quickly summarize here. Depending if you already have the Momentix ID set up, if you already have a license or a QNX trial, and then you can begin. I'll quickly play the video and comment over it. The first step is that you go to developer.toradex.com and browse for QNX, and you will find out that Toradex provides a partner demo image so that you can quickly evaluate QNX on the Toradex hardware. We also provide a step-by-step instructions that you can follow in order to make it easier. And as soon as you assemble and power on the hardware, you will notice that it comes installed with Toradex Easy Installer from factory. And it allows you to install QNX very easily. You just have to plug your computer or module to the internet, and in a few minutes, you have QNX running on the hardware. Here, I have rebooted the board after it's installed, and then I connect to the debug UART to get the board IP. You could also run other things from the command line, but the purpose here is to get the board IP and be able to connect to it from the Momentix IDE. So I create a QNX target device on Momentix, and then I connect using the network. With this partner demo image, a few applications come pre-installed, and they are sample applications, for instance, to test the graphics stack and graphics acceleration as well, as you see here on the GLES gears demonstration. You can also, for instance, test the touch screen and capture touch events to make sure that your hardware is properly connected in case you plan to build a graphical user interface. But once you finish evaluating pre-compiled applications, you'll probably want to create your own project. And here we do that in the Momentix IDE by creating a new project from the template. And then we add a breakpoint on some line here for demonstration purposes. And selecting our QNX target, we can run and remote debug the application on the target device. And for next steps, you can visit our developer website. Now, the next question is, how do I engage and what do I need to actually begin this hands-on evaluation? And to answer that question, I would like to hand over the presentation to Andrea from QNX.
Thank you, Leo. So after hearing all this, you might be wondering how to get in touch with us. So there's multiple ways. You can go to toradex.com operating systems QNX, and if you scroll down there, you can request access to a free Apalis i.MX 8 BSP. and other ready-to-use QNX images. Or you go to qnx.com, simply click on the Talk to Us button, leave us a note and your contact details so we can get back to you. And of course, you can also send us an email. Another thing you might want to do is, if you don't have hardware right away available, you might want to get an evaluation license to try out our software development platform. Please go to qnx.com, then click on Developers, then request a QNX evaluation license, fill out the form to get a MyQNX account, and don't actually forget to request the evaluation license once you register, and we will get the license to you and assist you also during your evaluation time. You can also contact sales from there. Where you can actually also meet us virtually this year will be at the Embedded World Conference. We are holding virtual roundtables on topics that might be of interest for you. The QNX ecosystem is much more than just a simple OS and tools. You've heard about our safety and security features and also about strategies, but there's more. There's a large ecosystem of platforms, products, services, and they are available to you and to help realize your designs. We work closely with our silicon vendors and board manufacturer partners. We also have a large ecosystem of partners, distributors, and value-added integrators, providing additional middleware products, hardware support, and other services for QNX. Our own professional service team is also there to help. We can offer architecture or porting assessments and can assess and make recommendations to help you get your ideas and products from where they are right now to where they need to go. And if we don't have it out of the box, just talk to us and we can work with you together via the QNX services to deliver a custom solution based on your requirements. And this by all means shows not everything that can be offered by BlackBerry QNX. So I hope you have learned a little bit more about us. And let me show you lastly how licensing works with us. We understand that it is a process selecting the right OS to base your development on. Factors like cost, performance, long-term support must be considered. We'll make it easy and transparent for our clients. Upfront purchase of development tools, support and training, annual support plans that will give customers access to bug fixes, patches, and latest software releases. We have custom service plans to get you access to our engineering services whenever you need them, and a cost-effective per kernel royalty model. With this model, we have to make sure our customers are successful during development, because otherwise they won't ship products. And if our customers' products are not successful, BlackBerry QNX will not be successful. Lastly, let me personally thank you very much for attending this webinar. We appreciate that you have dedicated your time to listen to us today. And with this, I would like to come to an end now and would like to hand over for Leo for our Q&A session. Thank you.
Thanks, Andrea. Before we jump into the Q&A, I would like to run one last poll. The question is, how likely is it that you will use QNX on your next project? I will keep it open for a few seconds so everybody has a chance to vote. Okay, I can see half the audience has had the opportunity to answer. Thanks, everybody. So we see one third of the audience is probably using QNX on their next project, and the other two thirds are between evaluation and interested in learning more about it. Thanks, and I'll start finding some questions. The first one here is the QNX evaluation a restricted version of the product? I think this one goes to the QNX team.
Okay, I guess not in sense being restricted in sense of the technology. A 30-day eval gives you access to the full QNX Neutrino RTOS and Momentix tools. I guess the main restriction being it's for evaluation use only, and you're not allowed, of course, to develop commercial products with this, but it's the full product.
Okay, thanks, Tom. The next question, it's a bit broad. Are there any limitations with the QNX hypervisor? I'm not sure if the attendee wanted to know something specific, but can you please comment a bit on it?
Yeah, maybe the limitation that first springs to mind for me is the support for certain operating systems as guests. QNX hypervisor supports Android and Linux, and it can also support other embedded operating systems. However, currently what is not supported is any version of Microsoft Windows. The reason for that simply is that Microsoft Windows demands, especially in its booting process, demands from a virtual environment a lot of more things than the virtualization extensions and hardware today provide. Windows requires interaction with ACPI, with BIOS, UEFI, and so on and so on, which is beyond the scope of the QNX hypervisor. So if you are interested in virtualizing Windows and running Windows as a guest OS, you would probably use the solution not from QNX directly, but from our partner, Real-Time Systems. They have developed a different approach to a hypervisor. Tom, maybe you can comment on that.
Yes, our RTS is a partner we work with as well. For this specific case of running QNX together with Windows, RTS is the solution there. They have a kind of a different, very, very strict separation mechanism to provide the ability to run both QNX and Windows in that case.
Yeah, right.
Okay.
Next question.
Thank you very much. Will I require hardware to get started with QNX?
Okay. So basically, not necessarily. So if you guys don't have the Toradex hardware platform yet, you can still get started checking out QNX via our basic QNX virtual machine. So QEMU, VMware, or VirtualBox images can be created by you. You should be able to find the doc explaining how to get started with these online at the links that I previously shown. And then once you have the Toradex platform, it should be a relatively simple matter of rebuilding your test cases for that platform if your applications are hardware independent.
Thanks, Tom. Is QNX a medically certified OS?
Yes, it is. The QNX office offers QNX OS for safety. Not only do we offer a medical certification to 62304 up to Class C, but I think I may have mentioned that we can do 61508 to SIL 3 and 26262 ASIL D.
Okay, thanks, Tom. I have a related question. As you talked about SIL 3, and can any of the platforms be paired with QNX Safety OS to target safety critical operation for functional safety as per IEC 61508 SIL 3 as an offering by Toradex? So on the QNX side, SIL 3 is achievable, correct?
Yes.
Correct.
Okay. As we've seen on Robert's presentation, NXP i.MX8X can get a certification up to SIL 3 because it has the ECC on RAM and all caches. And Toradex has one SKU of Apalis MX8X that also has the ECC on RAM, and it is certifiable up to SIL 3. But we'd like to take it forward offline and see the details and inform you on those.
Yeah, from a QNX perspective, so what QNX is offering is the so-called QNX OS for safety. Tom mentioned it. QNX, the QNX microkernel, is made to protect all software components from each other, but also from overwriting the kernel by mistake. And exactly those protection mechanisms are certified. So you can build up your own safety case based on those mechanisms. You don't have to certify all your software to the highest level anymore, not even drivers, like in Linux, for instance, or other operating systems where drivers run at a very high CPU privilege level. With QNX, they all are separated in user space processes. So from that point of view, they are protected. I recommend that if you have a safety critical project, be sure to talk with us. So we are not just a supplier of a safety certified operating system. We are also your partner in consulting and services. Many customers I'm meeting are doing their first safety critical project on a microprocessor coming from a microcontroller world. And they're trying to apply the thinking of the microcontroller world to the microprocessor world. That doesn't work. If for them, it's the first project they do with safety critical aspects in the microprocessor world. For us, it's maybe the nth project. So we have done tons of projects already. So come to us and benefit from our expertise. That would be my recommendation.
Okay. Well, thanks. I have a question here. How to get Toradex evaluation hardware? And all our computer modules are available from the Toradex shop. You can navigate to toradex.com and there you'll find directions to the web shop. Maybe I can quickly bring up here my web browser. I'm on the QNX page on toradex.com, but you can quickly find here in the shop. If you go through the QNX page, there is a benefit as I scroll down. You can see what ready to use QNX images we can provide. So we have images for Apalis MX8, Colibri MX8X, Apalis MX6, and Colibri MX6. Therefore, if you want to have an out of the box evaluation, you can use those platforms. Let me check for another question. Okay, I have a question here asking about support on i.MX8M+, which will be released. Perhaps Tom or Malte, you can comment on general support of QNX on other platforms or newer platforms.
I guess maybe the short answer is, it depends on the architecture. So if you've got a modern, ARM V8, or I'll say x86-64 platform, there's a good chance we can simply support it. And we do have a BSP list that's on the web. If you don't see what you want in that under those reference BSPs, simply get in contact us, and we'll be happy to discuss.
Right. So we have close relationships with the silicon vendors, for example, NXP and NXP, but the others as well, like Qualcomm, for instance, or Renesas. They all have departments working on QNX BSPs together with us. So if you, for example, see the latest NXP platform, the latest addition to the i.MX family, we will sooner or later support the reference design that NXP is creating based on their new silicon, as we work together on that. And based on that reference design, the computer on modules vendors and board vendors will create their own solutions, and BSPs can be easily adapted. We have a department, professional services, that is doing those adaptations together with our partners. So basically, as Tom just said, if it's an ARM V8 or an x86 64 bit, we can get it working.
Okay, thanks. And to complement, Toradex works with ARM-based computer modules. We either have the 32 bits ARM V7A with hard float, or the i.MX8 family that are all 64-bit ARM processors. So a very good likelihood that it works.
Yes, and Toradex is a partner for over two decades, I think. So as long as I'm with QNX, I know Toradex as a partner. So highly recommended to work with them.
Okay, moving to the next question. It's also a bit broad, but they ask about Linux RT patches versus QNX. And would you like to begin? Maybe I can say a few words about the Linux, or do you prefer to answer first?
No, go ahead.
Okay, well, Linux, they do have the preempt RT patches, which are the most famous ones, and they're supported by a few initiatives. And the big thing is that it's soft real time. So you cannot achieve hard real time with the Linux kernel. And I think that's from the perspective of real time, if you set aside everything else, the security and the safety, this is the biggest difference. Linux can only achieve soft real time, but of course there are a myriad of other things.
Yeah, I can comment on that. So let's be pretty clear here. Linux is a great achievement from a coding perspective, and I personally know a couple of Linux kernel developers, and they're doing a fantastic job. But whenever we discuss, or whenever I visit, I also sometimes visit a webinar just out of curiosity, real time and Linux, and they are spending enormous amounts of effort to solve some issues in Linux to get better real time, for instance, that just don't exist in QNX. so in my mind, it's always like, why spending so much time and effort to solve those issues in Linux? Just use QNX. So QNX is so close to Linux from an application point of view. It's POSIX compliant. It feels like a Linux. I mean, QNX, QNX, it is meant as a Unix-like OS. It's not based on the Linux kernel. It's a different kernel. But from an application point of view, it's quite close to Linux. Of course, not everything compiles directly out of the box, but porting is easy. And we can also support you with porting stuff from open source if something doesn't compile. And then you get all the real-time and all the security out of the box, so.
Okay, thank you very much for commenting. Yeah, I think we have questions here that are very specific. Here's one that we can answer quickly. Does QNX work with i.MX6? And from the Toradex perspective, we even have BSPs that have already been ported and are available from our partner, three of them.
Yeah, that's correct. You'll see those listed on our QNX BSP page as well.
Yes, as well as on Toradex page for QNX.
Okay, that's everything. I don't see any more questions coming in. I would like to thank everyone. I'd like to thank the audience for being with us today, and I would like to especially thank Robert from NXP, Thomas, Andrea, and Malti for joining this webinar.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Have a nice day. Bye bye.